Hello world, my name is Pia Riddertoft and I'm from Denmark. I work with the psychotherapy, I work with breathwork and I work with three principles. That makes me experience in people's feelings. Today I would like to talk about anger, and to that I have my dog Fearless in Danish Frygtløs, and he will demonstrate anger for you. Thank you so much, Fearless. I think that was a good demonstration. So when we talk anger, we talk energy. Anger is energy. And anger is energy coming from a thought. A thought is becoming a feeling, and a feeling is coming out in the body afterwards. And it is like that if it's possible to react on your feeling, then the thought that became a feeling that goes down to the body will become a rush of energy working out through your body. It will come out in your arms, out in your finger, in your jaws, in your neck, in all the body and the feeling. So if you could react on your anger, it was a good energy. And it is a good energy. It's a good energy if you were from a Neanderthal, or if you were an animal who have to protect yourself, your family, your loved ones, your village, or whatever you have to protect at that time. But today, anger is not so good an energy because it's not allowed to be angry. There's no place that you need so much anger that you have to protect yourself and your loved ones. Not so much anymore, and not in a modern society. In a modern society, anger is not allowed. It's not good looking. It's something that can take your worthiness and so on. So, and it also have the ability to take your charm away. It has the ability to make your loved ones suffer and yourself suffer. And a lot of the times anger, because it's not acting out, then you put it inside your body, so you're hurting in your spine and in your heart and in your stomach and so on. And sometimes it's just make your life sucks. So what can you do if your anger is becoming too much, or it's taking too much of your energy in the daily life and so on? What can you be doing? You can realize that anger is often towards the people you feel have the ability to hurt you or take something from you. It can be the boss, it can be a colleague, it can be a partner. And they are always, for the most of the time, they are lookalikes. They are lookalikes because they do something, say something, remind you of per person from your childhood who could take something from you, so who could make you feel something. So if you can find a way to forgive the people from your past, then they have no power over your now, over the way of your life now. So try to forgive the people from your past, so you're not seeing them in person that you meet in work or in love and so on. The other thing you can look at is, where do you feel helpless and powerless? Because it is feeling that is lying underneath anger. Most of the time you're not angry of the things you think you are angry of. You are angry because you feel hopeless, helpless, and powerless. So go down underneath the anger and see if you can make a solution there. Maybe you have to leave something, maybe you have to start something new, maybe you have to say something, stand up for yourself, or see whatever you can do. But because the anger is just something the system is trying to do to protect the feeling of vulnerability that's lie within that hopelessness, helplessness and powerlessness. So try to see what you really feel hopeless, helpless and powerless about and do something about that. The other thing is that you can also see if you feel deprived. The feeling of deprived, somebody have deprived something for you, from you, also can make you very angry. And see if you can reclaim it in some way. If somebody has take your worthiness, then reclaim it in something else. Do something new. And you can also see, and that is the most profound, is that your anger is in your thought. You can have chosen, without knowing it, more and more angry thoughts. You can invite a whole family of angry thoughts inside of you, inside your head. And you can have this motion going on in anger, anger, anger. And anger attracts anger. Anger always attracts anger. And again, it's not charming. It's not healthy. So see if you can find a way to give back to you, reclaim what you feel deprived of. And see if you can take your thoughts and make them more helpful. Just let go of the anger. I know it sounds easy, but where is your anger if you're not thinking upon it? Then it's gone. So try to reclaim your mind and use the mind of other things that makes you more happy. So your thoughts can be more happy. And then your feelings can be more happy. Your body can be more happy. And if all this is too difficult to do alone, then use some money to make more happy inside. You can take a therapist in your place in the world. Find one of them and say, help me. I don't want to be so angry anymore. And that was all for me today, and all for Fearless also. Bye-bye.